So you look at what value we are printing. We are printing I value. So it will print it this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So it will leave spaces in between the values because backslash T is the tab. T means tab. It works like horizontal tab. Okay. So between one value and another value, so some horizontal space is left here. Okay. So you look at the values here. One, between 1 and 2, 2, 1, 3, 3 and 4. Some space is there because of this backslash T. Okay. Same reason we can consider for do while loop also, but little bit coding will differ. Okay, just compare. Look here. So I is equals to 1. So when we write in terms of do while loop, okay. So here first you have to write the do statement. Okay, do, then open brace, co, I, so backslash t, I plus plus, okay. Closing brace, while I less than or equal to 5. The main difference here is for while loop you should not put semicolon. For do while loop after the condition you have to put the semicolon. The output is same. So closing and output both are same. Okay. So I will tell you the difference between while loop and do while loop here only. You just write out this time. So we'll put columns here. Okay. So we can consider that. While and do while. So you look at the example and you can analyze the difference. Okay, the difference is in case of while loop. Okay, in case of while loop, we will check the condition first. That means before statements are executed. So these are the statements of while loop: cout, I, and I plus plus. These are the two statements. Before we execute these two statements, condition is checked. So this is the condition. Okay. And in case of do while loop, after the execution of statements, condition is checked. So this is the condition check. Okay. So this is the first difference. Condition is checked at the beginning of the while loop. Condition is checked at the end of the do while loop. Or we can say in case of while loop, condition is checked at the first. That is beginning of the loop. In case of do while loop, condition is checked at the last. So it is called as, see, in case of while loop, we will call it as pre-tested looping statement. Okay. Pre-tested looping statement. Pre-tested looping. Pre means before. Okay. Before the execution of statements, condition is checked. If you look at the record from top to bottom, look at the code, first condition is checked, then the statements are executed. So it is called pre-tested. So before only we have to test the condition. So in case of do what to, if you look at the code, so in case of do what to, if you look at the code, the first statements are executed. Okay. Later this condition is checked. Condition is checked at the end. So statement 1 and 2, C of statement I plus plus are executed. So later condition is checked. So that means condition is checked after the statements are executed. In the case of while loop, condition is checked before the statements of while loop. Okay. So whenever you come across before, you say pre-tested condition. Whenever you come across after the execution of statements, condition is checked. So here I am telling after the execution of statements. After means we have to take test. Pre-tested looping statement in case of while loop, post-tested looping statement in case of do while loop. In one mark, we may get this question. Which loop is called as pre-tested looping statement? So I have to write while loop. And which loop is called as post-tested looping statement? I have to write do while loop. Okay, once again, I tell you, while loop is called as pre-tested looping statement, do while loop is called as post-tested looping statement because so condition is checked at the first. Condition is checked before the statements are executed. So it is called pre-tested. In case of do while loop, condition is checked after the execution of statements. So it is called as post-tested looping statement. Okay. And second difference is, okay, so you can write in statement also. Here you can write condition is checked at the beginning of the loop, condition is checked at the end of the loop. Okay, condition is checked at the beginning of the loop before execution of statements. Condition is checked at the end of the loop after execution of statements. In that way, you can write one. Now third one, So whenever we come across looping statements, you remember this point that whatever the looping statement you are using, that is while loop, do while loop, or for loop, three looping statements are there: while loop, do while loop, or for loop. Whatever the looping statements you use, so we have to think in the sense, we have to see how many times the statements of the loop are executed. How many times the statements of loop are executed? Okay, say statements of loop can be executed zero number of times, or one, or more than one time. Remember, statements of the loop means, see, in this case, these two are the statements of the loop. So whatever we have written in the opening brace and closing brace, these two are the statements of the loop. So here also, cout and I plus plus, these two are the statements of the loop. So between opening brace and closing brace, whatever we write, those are the statements of the loop. So in case of for loop also, same thing will come across. So statements of the loop can be executed zero number of times, one time, or more than one time. Okay. Now, two more things we have to consider. That is, minimum how many times the statements of loop are executed, and maximum how many times the statements of loop are executed. Okay, remember these points: minimum how many times the statements of loop are executed, maximum how many times the statements of loop are executed. Okay. So when we go for maximum number of times, in all the three, while loop, do while loop, for loop, infinite number of times statements of loop are executed. Remember, infinite number of times statements of loop are executed. That is maximum number of times. When we come to the minimum number of times, then one thing we have to consider, that is, you see the condition. Okay, if the condition becomes false for the first time itself, remember this point. If the condition becomes false for the first time itself, then the number of times the statements are executed is minimum. Okay, I'll tell you, if the condition becomes false for the first time itself, in case of while loop, do while loop, and for loop, then the statements of loop are executed is minimum. If the condition never becomes false, it is always true forever, then we can consider maximum number of times. So I'll tell you when we have to consider minimum and maximum. The first thing what you have to remember is, in case of looping statements, statements of loop can be executed zero number of times, okay, or one time, or more than one time. That is many times. Statements of loop, that is while loop, do while loop, and for loop, can be executed zero times, or one time, or more than one time. Okay. Next, second point what you have to remember is, minimum how many times, okay, then you will, third one, maximum how many times. Minimum how many times, maximum how many times. So in case of maximum, you can simply write infinite number of times the statements of loop are executed. See, when I say infinite number of times the statements of loop are executed, means you have to tell the situation. At what situation this happens? Situation is, if the condition is, see, condition is always true, then only it will execute like infinite number of times. And if there are no break statements in loop, two cases you have to remember, which condition is always true, and if there is no break statements in the loop, then it will execute infinite number of times. So again, I will tell you, if the condition is always true, and if there is no break statement in the loop, then maximum number of times looping statements are executed is infinite. Minimum how many times means, here you have to consider, condition is false for the first time. See, when we consider looping statement, condition can become false for the first time, condition can become false for the second time or third time, or we don't know at what point condition may become false. Again, I will tell you, condition may become false for the first time itself, or it can become false for the second time or third time, or we don't know how many or what situation condition will become false. If the condition never becomes false, then we will consider it is always true. It will execute infinite number of times. Okay. Now, if it is false for the first time, so this case we will consider. If it is false for the first time, minimum number of times in case of while loop is zero. That means statements of loop will never execute if the condition is false for the first time. So only I have written, general I have written. Zero number of times can be executed, one time can be executed, more than one. So if you consider zero number of times, I have written. If you consider more than one, maximum how much? Infinite. If you consider more than one time, maximum is infinite. If you consider minimum, that is zero. Minimum is zero, maximum is infinite. So in case of while loop, okay. Now coming to the do while loop, even though condition is false for the first time, remember, even though the condition is false for the first time, one time the statements of loop will be executed. One time the statements of loop will be executed. First of all, you have to remember some important points here. Looping means process of repetition of execution of statements. Looping means process of repetition of execution of statements. It can be zero or one or more than one. So if I tell more than one, maximum is infinite. That means condition is always true. If I tell zero or one, that means minimum. Minimum means in case of while loop and do while loop. You consider in case of while loop and do while loop. In case of while loop, minimum number of times is zero. In case of do while loop, minimum number of times is one time. But the infinite for all loop, while loop, do while loop, for loop, maximum means it is infinite. When you consider minimum, zero number of times in case of while loop, one time in case of do while loop. The situation also has to be tell. That is when the condition is false for the first time. When the condition is false for the first time, minimum number of times the statements of while loop is executed is zero. If the condition is false for the first time, minimum number of times statements of do while loop is executed is one time. And if the condition is always true, maximum number of times the looping statements are executed for all while do while and for is infinite. Okay. Now, for the last one, I'll show you by example. So these differences we've asked in the exam, so I will give you in the notes. Okay, when I send the notes, I will give you in the notes. Difference like in column wise, I will give you. Okay, I don't know. See, when we write a condition like this, you see, okay, while I greater than 1, okay, the out, just consider this while loop, okay, considering I is equals to 1, okay. Next, same code you consider for do while loop, I is equals to 1, do, C out, okay, I, while I greater than 1. See, nothing have changed here. Same condition, same initial value, same statement in the loop. Okay, I is equals to 1, in case of do while also I is equals to 1. Condition is I greater than 1, here also I greater than 1. Okay. And C out I, and here also C out I. Okay. Now we will consider what will be the change in the output. Okay. I will try to analyze this code. When you try to analyze this code, see I is equals to 1, you check the condition by writing the value. Okay. I is equals to 1, I greater than 1, you substitute the value of I here. So what is the value of I here? Value of I is 1. Is 1 greater than 1? Can anybody tell the answer? Chat and tell. Just think logically. Is 1 greater than 1? Whether it is true or false? 1 greater than 1? Whether it is true or false? 1 greater than 1? No, no means false. Is 1 greater than 1? No, no means this condition is false. So whenever you come across less than and greater than symbol, remember, for less than and greater than symbol, if both sides same values are there, then it is false. If LHS and RHS both contain the same value, then it is false. Easy to remember. you come across less than or greater than symbol without equals to sign. If LHS and RHS both contain same value, then it is false. So one greater than one false. So when the condition is false, immediately it will come out of the loop without going to the statement. This statement will not execute. See, I am checking condition for the first time. First time only condition is false. So we have to say zero number of times statements of loop are executed. This statement is not executed. Not executed means zero number of times. So nothing will be there on the blank. Blank. Nothing. On the output is nothing. Understood. I hope you got people got it. Condition is checked for the first time. For the first time only condition is false. So statement is not executed. That means zero number of times it is executed. So for this difference, I am giving the example. So it will be easy for you to write it. Instead of memorizing, it will be easy for you to write. Minimum number of times the statements of while loop are executed zero means in this way. To write the code in such a way that you should understand how many zero number of times it is executed. So here the statement is not executed. So I can say not executed. Not executed means zero number of times. See, and the output will not print zero. It doesn't print anything. Meaning it is not executed. Now coming to the do while loop. Okay, when you come to the do while loop. I is equals to 1, condition is same. See here, before you check the condition, there is one statement. See, program control will flow like this, right? From line by line, it will flow. When I press F7 key, it should be. Line by line, it will flow. So when it comes across do, okay, do keyword, after do keyword, opening brace is there. After opening brace, one statement is there. See, I is there, I. Okay, you substitute this value. See, before you substitute the value in the condition, you substitute here. Okay, don't go to condition directly. You substitute here first. Okay, when you substitute here, one is there. So that one is printed. Because COT is there, that one is printed. Whatever the statements are right, that will be executed. There I have written COT because just to understand better. So one is printed. Later you check the condition. When you check the condition, substitute the value. One greater than one. Same condition. Same condition means it is false. 1 greater than 1 is false. Now you have to stop. See, for the first time in both the cases, condition is false only. But in case of do while loop, before you check the condition only, it is printed. Later you are checking the condition. After checking the condition, you can say statement is not executed. But first time it is executed, right? So this statement is executed one time. One time it is executed. So only I have written here one time. Minimum number of times the statements of do while loop executed is one time. Because condition we are checking at the end. Before checking the condition, the statement got executed. So you should say 1. In case of console screen, this one. See, not because it is executed only one time, it is printing 1. You have used the value 1, so it is printing 1. So if suppose if you take I is equals to 10, it will print 10. Okay, like that. Whatever the value you use, it will print like that. So here I have taken 1, so it is printing 1. So if output is blank, you can say it is 0 number of times. If something it is printing on the output, then it is what time. So now we will execute this program. So let me share this.
You just tell me whether screen is visible or not. Okay. So is the TurboSQL editor screen visible for all of you? Okay, fine. I'll execute. So I will go with the while loop once again. So I will try to understand. Okay. So this is the while loop. Okay. One more important point here is, see, whenever you trace the program, that is control statements program, that is while loop, do while loop and for loop. So what you have to do is, see, just you keep track of this variable. So I will show you when you have to consider the variable. Now I will execute this program by keeping F7 key in mind, that is tracing. You just observe here. See, this is the program control, okay. I is equals to 1, then clear screen. See, when program control comes to this point, see, if you want to execute line by line, that is, if you want to know the program control, OK, Okay, if you want to know the program control, then one thing what you have to do is like you just keep track of this variable's value. You go to the debug option. Okay, inspect is there, no? There you type I. Okay, when you type I, we'll come to know the value. See, on the top right corner, I value is visible. Now chat and tell whether it is visible or not. Top right corner, I value is 1 on your screen. Is it visible for all of you? Okay, fine. Okay, so just observe that variable. Okay, how it changes you should notice. Okay, so only, so that only you can understand the tracing part. See, otherwise what happens, just you will be looking at the program control but you will not come to know the value and how many times it is repeated. And now you just observe the two things you have to observe: program control plus value. Okay, see, I less than or equals to 5, 1 less than or equals to 5, condition is true. C out I, so that value will be printed on the screen. Okay, see, immediately after this I plus plus, you see how I value changes. You look at the top right corner and just you keep observing that value, how it changes. See, I value is changed to 2, am I right? So I value is changed to 2. Now you check the condition, 2 less than or equals to 5, condition is true, again it prints. So this is how statements of loop are repeated. This is called repetition of execution of statements. So now observe, when program control goes to the condition while I less than or equals to 5, you see the value top right corner, how it changes. See, I value is changed to 3 because I plus plus is there. I plus plus means it will increase by 1. Okay, again condition is true, so it will be printed again. Okay, okay, now again you observe the program control. When it moves to the condition I less than or equals to 5, how it changes. So I value is 4. Okay, I hope everybody are looking at the value also simultaneously, the way it is changing. Okay, next, condition is true, it prints. And see, I plus plus is there, so I value is 5. Now both I value is 5 and the final value is 5, but it is equal. 5 less than or equals to 5 is true because it is equal. Equals to sign is there, right? It is equal, so it is true. Okay, it prints, I value will print. Now I value should change to 6. You just observe how it changes. So I value is 6. Okay, 6 less than or equals to 5, condition is false. So if the condition is false, immediately program control will go to the getCH function, because the line which is present after the while loop is getCH. See here. Okay, so getCH is executed. So it prints 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now I will show you do while loop. Okay, okay. Now you see the program control, how it flows. Okay, clear screen is there. So here again you keep track of the variable I. Say I value is 1. Okay, I hope for everyone it is visible. You see, before condition is checked, that is I less than or equals to 5. C out statement is executed. That is, first statements of loop are executed, afterwards condition is checked. So still condition is not checked here. Okay, first statements of loop are executed, two statements. That is C out and I plus plus. Okay, I plus plus. So here you keep track of the variable. See, after the execution of I plus plus, you see how the value changes. Top right corner, that is the I value. 1 is the I value. Its data type is int. Okay. See, I value changed to 2. It checks the condition. 2 less than or equals to 5. Yes, condition is true. So when the condition of the do while loop is true, program control will start from the loop, starting of the loop. Starting of the loop means again C out statement. Okay. C out I. Okay. It prints. Okay. Now I plus plus is there. Before when it goes to condition, the value will be changed. See, I value is 3 here. It will check 3 less than or equals to 5, condition is true. Again, statements of loop are executed. Okay, I plus plus is there, so I value is changed to 4. Okay, again it is printed. Okay, I plus plus is there. You just observe the top right corner value, I value. So I value is 5. Okay, 5 less than or equal to 5, condition is true. So I plus plus is there. So now it changes to 6. You just observe. See, 6. Now you tell me what is the condition. 6 less than or equal to 5. 6 less than or equal to 5, condition is false. So because the condition is false, it will not go to the loop again. It will come out. Okay, there it stops, it comes out. So output is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So for both the programs, output is same, right? So as I said, we cannot notice the difference here. But when I change the code, you just observe what I do here. Okay. Okay. See here. While I greater than 1. Okay, see how type plus plus. So now look here. See, I have written the code in such a way that first time only condition should become false. So like that I have written. First time only condition should become false. So just observe here, program control. So I have written condition I greater than 1. Value of I is also 1. So 1 greater than 1, condition will be false. First time only condition will be false. You just observe here. Clear screen. See, I greater than 1, 1 greater than 1, because you look at the value of I. So I value is 1, right? So 1 greater than 1. So 1 greater than 1 is false. So when you use greater than symbol, less than symbol, if LHS and RHS both are same, then the condition will be false. Okay, so here I value is 1, right side value is also 1. 1 greater than 1, condition is false. Okay, 1 greater than 1, condition is false. You just observe how program control will directly move to the get CH. See here. That means statements of loop, statements of while loop are not executed. Again, I will tell you, statements of while loop are not executed. So you should write zero number of times. Zero number of times statements of while loop are executed when the condition is false for the first time. So you just observe the output. Nothing is there. I think I have shown in the board also, nothing. Only cursor will be blinking. Black screen, cursor will be blinking. So you should write zero number of times statements of while loop are executed when the condition is false for the first time. Now same thing, I will little bit, I will change the code. We just see. So what I do is, like, I will bring this while loop at the end. Okay. Okay. Now I just say do. Now you see what happens. Okay. Same coding, condition is same, initial value is same, cout statement is same, I plus plus, everything is there. Only thing is I have written first do, then while. Okay. I have to give semicolon here. Okay. Okay. Now you observe the program control. I equal to 1. So you just check the I value. So I is equals to 1. So now before the condition is checked, first time before the condition is checked, one time statements of loop are executed. See, cout is executed one time. Okay. One time cout is executed. One time I plus plus is also executed. Later it will check the condition. So by the time it checks the condition, I value has become 2. So condition is false. Okay. Just a minute. So here we should not write I plus plus. Okay. You just see here. See, one time I value will be printed. That is value 1. Now it checks the condition. Okay. See, 1 greater than 1. Okay. Condition is false. It will stop. You just see the output. 1 is printed. So one time do while loop is executed. So statement what you have to write is, in case of do while loop, if the condition is false for the first time, statements of loop are executed is one time. In case of while loop, statements of while loop are executed 0 times. So this you have to write. Now we'll go with the for loop concept. Okay. See, for loop example execution we will see tomorrow. Okay, time over. So we will see tomorrow. Okay, tomorrow I will explain this for loop example program with tracing also, program control tracing, and different ways of writing for loop also I will tell you. Okay.